So there's a couple of ways, just if you follow them, that you can actually get into your timesheet. You can have your toolbar, you can set this up the way you'd like, so under manage time and expenses, or you can go up here to the top, and also, you know, arrive at the place where you're going to manage time and expense. And what Dan had mentioned earlier to me, we'll just do a click on that, it's going to retrieve my timesheet. So I'm going to see more information than your employees would if we set up the security, that they would only their particular timesheet. Let me just get a little bit of time up here, and I'm able as an employee to be able to go back and look at any range of timesheets that I might have worked on. So I may just bring up January. I'll get a little bit more option here to look and view my timesheet. So I have the 18th, the 11th, and so forth. So I can either double click, do a quick double click on that, or hit the next button and I'm retrieve. And we're just kind of stick with that one project we're kind of looking at earlier. I'm going to do a little open height. It's going to look up a project number, a project name, and look that had a pre-design phase. And it, if it didn't see a pre-design phase, just be able to go in and bring up my phases, design documents. And for those who use something like a labor code or an activity code or a different application, they call them different things, different software. I have billable time here, and I can simply to start the extra hours. In any one cell, if I just highlight the cell, something may be used. Now I'm able to have a free text field here, comments. Now those comments can show on your billing, I spoke with, and they show it on the management report. So once you make a comment, it makes this little squeaky line here for a highlight. That is kind of cool features, so I kind of turn my timer on. I just kind of increment the hours here and I stop the time. It's going to do an autofill for me that to put in those hours. And I would just continue to do my time for that particular item and then move forward. If I had a different piece of time on a different phase, schematic design, and now I'm doing project management, I'm able to populate that time off. So you can see this, so the billable time is going to be total here. I've got 2 hours of billable on Monday, 1 hour of billable on a Wednesday. And then at the section down here, if you just kind of use this little toolbar here, it'll expand and kind of retract that section. And I'm able to track my vacation, sick, holiday. I've got some general overtime here and holiday. So those counts on the line, there is functionality to track sick and vacation accruals as well as this timesheet actually will populate, and I'll show that in a second, to those who still do in-house payroll and function. So I can save my timesheet at this point, and then I would do a process of submitting it and actually submit that timesheet. And then from there, if you have a